is Cable's and Deadpool's issue 41, and despite the bad cover, this is actually a pretty good comic. It is a crossover with the Excellent Men's, and there they all are. This is Cable's. This one is Cannonball's. He's one of my favourite characters, actually. This one is Snowman. This is before he became a stereotype, back when he was an actual character. This is Mistake, and during this one, Snowman and Mistake are actually in a relationship. Like, it's really steamy, and it's a nice little bit of romance. This one is Rouge. You'll recognise her from the cartoon. This is R2-D2. You might remember her from the review I did last week, the Dr. X solo book. She was in that one. And this woman here, she is really pretty. Like, really, really sexy, isn't she? Like, I want to read more comics about her. Like, she's really cute. I think I fancy her, to be honest. And the story of this one, there's actually quite a sad little behind-the-scenes story. The writer of The Excellent Men's decided he wanted Cables to join The Excellent Men's. So this book, since issue 37, I think, has lost creative control of Cables. So it effectively lost one half of its main characters. And the next issue, the one after this one, that's actually the last one to feature Cables at all. After that, it just kind of becomes a Deadpool's book. But it's still called Cables and Deadpool's for some reason. It is cancelled by issue 50, so it doesn't last that much longer. The story is spinning out of the Excellent Men's. Cables, he has his own country, like it's meant to be an island paradise, like Utopia on Earth. But in the Excellent Men's issue, the country got destroyed and it's like falling apart and stuff. And this is like Cables' government. This woman, she is really, really hot. Like, she is one of my favourite ones, her. This guy is like the head of the communications, and he's like plugged into the internet and the network and stuff like that. And he's having a bit of a panic attack because the island's like sinking and stuff, and there's too much communications coming in. And what's happening is Sabreclaw is on the loose. Sabreclaw was a member of the Excellent Men's, but against his will. So first chance he got, he fled and started killing people. And he's loose on the island now. So Cables meets up with Domino's, and he is like, I like this little bit here. He's like, Creed is on the loose. And then we've just got this little silent panel here showing her worried expression. That is really good. And what they're going to do is Cables, he is going to go and delete all the memory banks of his computers so there's no sensitive data left lying around. And Domino's is going to go and stop Sabreclaw. And then we've got like all the residents of Cable's country, they're leaving and they're quite sad about it. They're like, I liked it here. And then Domino's finds the communications guy has been murdered by Sabreclaws. And Sabreclaws is holding the woman hostage. And he's like, don't come any closer or I'll kill her. And I think this is the first proof that Sabreclaws is gay, because why on God's green earth would you ever want to kill this woman? She is really, really hot. She's like beautiful. She's one of my favorites. I don't approve of killing her. And then it's really good because Deadpool shows up, and it's like, it's not a big joke or like a silly wacky thing. He just shows up and he's like the hero. He's saving the day. He's shooting his guns. He starts blasting Sabreclaws, and the woman gets to escape. And then we have this really, really good little fight between Deadpools and Sabreclaws. He's just like shooting them again and again with his submachine guns. And he's like, I know what you're thinking, you've got to run out of bullets soon, but what's going to happen first? Am I going to run out of bullets, or will there be nothing left of you to heal? And then Cables, he manages to delete the memory banks, and then he says goodbye to the woman. This is like his vice president woman, and he's like, you were a really good vice president. Weirdly enough, he doesn't mention at all that she is really, really hot. And then on the next page, he kisses Domino's. And I tell you what, this Cables guy, he's a bit of a stud, isn't he? Like, she fancies him. He's got Domino's. He used to go out with Storms. I think he's a total player. And then Deadpools and Sabreclaws are still fighting. I tell you what, actually, right? Domino's and her, I'd be up for that threesome. That is like, that would be like heaven to me. Deadpools, he's still fighting Sabreclaws, and he's like cutting up his tendons and stuff. And this is my favourite part of the comic, because Cables shows up and he sees them fighting. And I'm actually just going to read this bit because I like it that much. Cables, he sees them fighting and he's like, "You can't be killed by conventional means, and we don't have time for anything complicated. Options. Try to restrain him until I destroy the archives. He'll likely survive the detonation. Let Wade keep him occupied until I destroy the archives. They'll both probably survive the detonation. The hell with it. Hello, Wade. Goodbye, Victor." And he just uses his telekinesis to like throw him dead far away. And Deadpools is like, "Oh, where'd you toss him to?" And Cables is just like, "That way." And then we see he's in the middle of the ocean, and Cables is saying, "Where it should take him a very, very long time to swim to land." It's really cool that I really like it. And then Cables, he's like saying thank you to Deadpools, because sometimes they're like, they're at each other's throats, but they're at the core, they're friends, and I like that. This is a really good comic, really. I recommend it. I rate it 7 thumbs up.